We're really excited and thrilled to be funded by PCORI to evaluate in a very rigorous fashion an important question for people living with multiple sclerosis, which is really to get at how we should be addressing people with respect to disease-modifying therapies. We now have several disease-modifying therapies approved by the FDA for people living with MS that do a pretty good job at preventing relapses and new white spots in the brain and the spinal cord, although they have a difference in terms of how efficacious they are. What we don't really understand is how to treat people. Should everybody be treated the same way at the beginning, or are there different strategies that apply to different types of people living with multiple sclerosis? Should we be giving everybody really aggressive therapies up front? Or should we start in sort of a more stepwise approach, escalating therapies only if the disease doesn't respond to the earlier medications? So that's the question we're really hoping to address with this trial. I speak from the perspective of a clinician when I say that I hope the Treat MS trial actually helps me in my day-to-day encounters with my patients and helps them as well, so that instead of saying, I'm not exactly sure what the strategy should be for you now that you've been diagnosed with MS, I'm going to guess that we should do this or that. Instead, I can say, based on the evidence from the trial, I think because you have low risk indicators for disability, we can start you on, you know, this therapy and then observe and escalate as needed. Or maybe we'll find out, actually, we need to give everybody pretty strong medication right out of the gate, regardless of their baseline risk strata. And that would be great to just sort of base our decisions and the way that we advise people on actual hard evidence rather than sort of guessing. We will be looking at a lot of really interesting patient-reported outcomes, such as quality of life metrics, things like social status. Does this different treatment strategy impact long-term stability in relationships, whether partnerships or marriages, that sort of thing? How about jobs and employment, things that trials traditionally don't look at? So I think we have a lot of neat opportunities. We have a great statistical team. We're really thrilled.